Think twice before taking flight. 100 setbacks. Stand upright. Good morning. Today is Tuesday, August 6, 2024. Today in history, on this day 143 years ago, British bacteriologist and microbiologist Alexander Fleming was born. Fleming discovered lysozyme in 1923 and penicillin in 1928. Penicillin's discovery revolutionized medicine by providing an effective treatment for bacterial infections, ending an era when such diseases were often untreatable. Fleming was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for his groundbreaking work. Qing Qiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Qing Qiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. Vietnam President Tham Lam succeeds as party chief. According to the Vietnam News Agency, on August 3, Tham Lam succeeded the late Nguyen Phu Trong as the General Secretary of the Communist Party of Vietnam, becoming the highest leader of Vietnam. Tham Lam had previously been appointed acting General Secretary on July 18, following Nguyen Phu Trong's serious illness and subsequent death on the 19th. Political observers had anticipated that Tham Lam would lead the succession. Vietnam's leadership is structured around a four-pillar system, consisting of the General Secretary of the Communist Party, the President, the Prime Minister, and the Chairman of the National Assembly. Tham Lam, 67, previously served as Minister of Public Security and was a key figure in the anti-corruption campaign, earning the trust of Nguyen Phu Trong. His appointment may signal the end of recent internal power struggles in Vietnam. Obama campaign team joins Harris campaign. According to the New York Times, on August 2, U.S. Vice President Harris, who has secured the Democratic presidential nomination, is restructuring the campaign team initially set up for Biden's re-election. Several advisors from former President Obama and former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's teams have joined, including Plouffe, who was Obama's chief advisor in his first campaign, and Carter, Obama's deputy campaign manager in 2012. With fewer than 100 days until the U.S. presidential election, these new members bring significant campaign experience. A Harris campaign spokesperson noted that the team raised $310 million in political donations in July, more than double the $130 million raised by Republican candidate Trump. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. Russia raises contract soldier wages to boost military expansion. According to Reuters, Russian President Vladimir Putin recently announced an increase in the minimum annual salary for recruits serving in Ukraine to 3.25 million rubles for their first year, with higher salaries for officers. Additionally, all Russians who sign military contracts will receive an advance payment of 400,000 rubles. Local authorities are also encouraged to allocate the same amount from their budgets to motivate soldiers. This salary increase means that the minimum annual salary for Russian contract soldiers in Ukraine will be over three times the average salary in Russia. Following a mass exodus to neighboring countries in 2022, Russia implemented a contract soldier system to avoid nationwide conscription. The government has also introduced measures to support contract soldiers, such as waiving monthly interest payments on consumer loans for volunteers and providing state guarantees for such loans in case of death. Russia reported that 490,000 contracts have been signed in 2023, with about 190,000 volunteers already fighting in Ukraine this year. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. Thailand seeks public opinion on legalizing casinos. Comprehensive news from Bangkok. The Thai government has recently launched a public consultation on draft regulations for legalizing casinos. According to the draft, large-scale entertainment venues, including casinos, hotels, convention centers, and amusement parks, must be located in government-designated areas. Owners must be Thai-registered companies with a capital of at least 10 billion baht. The draft proposes a 30-year operating license for casinos, with an option for a 10-year renewal. Additionally, the government plans to establish an entertainment venues policy committee led by the Prime Minister and a dedicated agency to oversee the gaming industry. Thailand is promoting casino legalization to attract tourists and foreign investment. A report by Thai lawmakers suggests that legalizing casinos could generate an additional $12 billion in tourism revenue. Now, here is some important safety information. Haniyeh assassination exposes security flaws, Iran investigates 20+. According to the New York Times, on August 3, Iran arrested more than 20 individuals from the Tehran military, including senior intelligence officials and military personnel. This followed the assassination of Hamas leader Haniyeh in an explosion on July 31, which occurred shortly after the swearing-in of Iran's new president. The incident highlighted significant security lapses in the heavily guarded compound. Two Iranian officials revealed that the Iranian Revolutionary Guard's intelligence department, responsible for espionage, is leading the investigation and arresting suspects. They aim to identify those who planned and executed the assassination. Details of the investigation will be released later. Vaze, a senior advisor at the International Crisis Group, commented that the incident underscores Iran's failure to protect both its own territory and its key allies. U.S. sues TikTok for mass child privacy violations. According to Reuters, on August 2, the U.S. Department of Justice sued TikTok and its Chinese parent company ByteDance for failing to protect children's privacy. The lawsuit alleges that TikTok violated the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act, which requires parental consent before collecting personal information from users under 13 years old. TikTok, with about 170 million users in the U.S., is the international version of the Chinese platform Douyin and is popular among young people. President Biden signed a bill on April 24 requiring ByteDance to sell TikTok by January 19, 2025, or face a U.S. ban. TikTok and ByteDance challenged this order in the U.S. Court of Appeals for the District of Columbia Circuit on May 7, arguing it infringes on constitutional protections, including the First Amendment. This lawsuit represents the latest U.S. action against TikTok and ByteDance. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Scientists develop new water purification material. According to Xinhua News Agency, an international research team including Kyoto University recently reported in Nature Communications on advancements in water purification technology. Traditional methods mainly rely on ion adsorption through small pores or ion exchange, often struggling to balance removal efficiency and selectivity. Researchers noted that some animals and plants use proteins to selectively bind heavy metal ions and protect themselves from poisoning. For instance, plants use phytochelatins to capture and sequester heavy metals like cadmium in vacuoles. Inspired by this, the team designed a synthetic polymer with functional groups similar to those in phytochelatins. This polymer can selectively capture large amounts of toxic heavy metal ions from water, significantly enhancing the purification of industrial wastewater. This represents a major advancement in environmental protection technology. Financial newsletter. According to Xinhua Finance, the offshore RMB has recently risen by over 400 basis points against the US dollar, reaching a maximum of 7.1251, marking a new high since January. That's all for today's Qingqiao Morning News. Thank you for listening.